all of the Swedish players are obviously very skilled. The pistol is underway. And seems like a alley rush or slow kind of alley explosion is coming out of AliGon.
And I like the decoy and also the smoke getting put down by Reason there. Let's see what they're going to be able to accomplish here. They're definitely going to push this hard very soon. Nether's going to be in for quite the surprise. Although there's another good re-smoke. And good to see all the nades coming out from Reason on this pistol. And look at this. They're just charging on through the smoke. They want to go. They want to go now. AliGon are going to make a couple kills. Kadian, though, with a response onto Zealous. So they only have to worry about Ali right now. And all the T players incoming from that angle. I'm going to T Sky. Kadian is on a roll right now. Can he get any more? Just so violent right now. That USP gets another kill. Kadian, what a monster. He's 1-1 against Pife now. Pife's got plenty of time, though, to get that bomb down. And the pace will drop.
Kadian go for the ace.
He's looking to do it for sure. Let's jump onto Kadian here as he tries to make this ace a reality. Pife lurking to the right. He's going to spot him, but Pife just snaps his neck straight away in Kadian. Even though he took four players down, he couldn't, his team couldn't do it. And how depressing is that? You're like, guys, I killed four. None of you could kill one. What is this?
Hopefully he's not saying that to his
team. No, that would be bad.
I like the AliGon push out Ali. They got the entries and they put the CTs in an awkward position. Kadian went huge there anyways, but could have been so much easier for AliGon because they kind of fake going CT spawn and then push through all the trains at the same time, which worked out great for them, except for Kadian firing those bullets.
Oh my god, Zealous with that PT-50. The accuracy is just unreal. And MSL now going to come in with his PD-50, see what he's able to accomplish. Getting a kill or two would be so nice. He's able to get that, but shut down. So AliGon, they won the pistol.
Yep.
So that is amazing. That is amazing. They're racking up those rounds off of the ecos. And I guess you'd expect no shenanigans to come from Reason, because I guess that, like you said, you were expecting to see an AWP on Kadian, so they can't really be buying weirdly until they can afford that AWP.
I think this is working out really well for AliGon. They kind of have that pistol, they have the rounds to kind of take those risks they want to do as a mixed team and just play their heart out. And we're seeing that right now in the anti-eco as well. Just smashing four players at almost once. And Delphine going for the last one. Clean anti-eco.
Okay.
This is where it gets interesting for the T's. Because we got AWP on Delphine, AWP on Kadian, but I'm feeling like they're going to be really aggressive, AliGon. Really, really aggressive. And we just have to see.
There's the AWP is converging.
Flashing out Pop Dog.
Just nice leg shot there.
Just mowing out. Just taking duels.
And here come the smokes. This is really going to hurt Kadian's angles. And PNX, wow, what an angle to find, actually. No smoke or flashes to block that one. Bomb does go down, and PNX going to jump on top. They don't expect this. He gets another great kill. And Pive gets caught as well. It's just Zevis. And he's in a bit of a nasty spot here. Oh, there goes one defuse. He's got to sprint around, but it's no time. Kadian going to shut him down. Very well handled there by Reason. That was a nice entry from AliGon into Yard.
Yeah. They got the after plant situation, but it's always really, really hard having an after plant when CTs can be on so many different angles. You kind of have to block off some and try to focus on others, but Reason made the pushes through smokes. They made the perfect. They took a duel, another one took a duel, and they just crumbled them in a sense. As they trying the same round again, AliGon.
And they go for that split onto the A bomb site through Pop Dog, through T main. PNX again, very nasty. Is he from that position at T Sky? Kadian as well, responsive as ever. And they just can't seem to make any grounds here. And PNX is just going so huge with his M4. Three frags in that round. I mean, AliGon, they just can't make that work, it seems. I mean, what is there a way that you could see AliGon improving that rush there?
I just think that their setup reason has gives the the rotator the time to actually go back in the rotation, and they kind of mash them in a very aggressive position for the T, where it looks like T has the advantage, but it's kind of a trap where baiting them to go far in into the yard area and just picking off one by one.
I think PNX is really showing a masterclass from this position as well. He's really doing such good work too, and looks like they're going to go for a bit more of a split here. We're going and seeing some pressure on Ali as well as main and Pop Dog as well. But it looks like they're not really coming together at once here. I mean, they're losing a couple of frags there. It looks like maybe they're going for a fake perhaps to push their way into B.
PNX gets two kills through the smoke in Ali.
He's unstoppable, and looks like indeed the bomber's going towards B right now. But it feels like AliGon aren't really sure of how to deal with this. And right now, Reason are definitely in great positions to handle all this. Their communication is probably fantastic at this point. Ooh, Nilla, good position actually, using that little bar very well to take down two players. Unbelievable, there's the third as well from Nilla.
How did he survive? He had a nade in his hand.
I don't even know. That's the rule. If you see someone with a nade in their hand, it's like the most embarrassing thing to die to yeah. them, isn't it? I mean, you get like a head start. It's crazy. Apparently that little bar is too strong.
Yeah, I think AliGon should probably try to push inner, or at least try to split inner and have the rotation inner, because the AWP is kind of screwing them from CT main, and they're doing the same pushes again and again. This time it's kind of working out when they don't have guns.
Wow, Dalpan. He just goes straight, beeline, straight for the AWPer, and he picks up the frag, he picks up the AWP, gets another one. PNX though, he just can't be touched. Has PNX even died? I don't even know. I don't think so. Okay, he's died a few times, but it feels like he doesn't die.
He's always there.
He is always there. And it feels like he's almost a ghost, invisible, because I don't ever see, you know, when he's working that T-Sky angle, it's rare that you see them actually shooting towards him. His timing, I guess, is just great when he decides to take the angles.
Probably timing on the anti-flashes from his teammates. So they have good communication. Dalpan going for a risky shot in Pop Dog, punished by EXR. They are 4 on outside, and this is not really working out for AliGon. They're losing members left and right, and they don't seem to have a real good plan.
I'm just happy that they got the pistol round, because I don't know if they're going to get any more rounds after that. That's a little series that they picked up. So either way, it's all about getting that first frag, getting that entry frag. If they can explode off of something like that, build off of it, they can make anything happen. They're so good, but they just can't quite seem to get those frags every single time. Reason step in. They get the first kill. They stop everything. And Kadian with his trusty CZ to finish off Zelos. 5-3.
I think I would love to see a 5-man inside round, but it's coming to the point where when they go outside, they rush it. And so if they go inside very slowly, wait for the smokes, etc., it's going to be pretty obvious that they're going inside. So they got a problem on their hands right now.
So they're going to go down Pop Dog with a couple of players, maybe try to get some picks. They're pretty spread out at the moment with all these pistols. And
they actually
bought. Good aim from Nilo, good tracking with that AK-47, going to pick up two. And again, they are just getting absolutely mauled here on the outside. Kadian just not even going to bother with the AWP. See Zedding people down, and it's just Zevas left at this point, going to go for that plant, but too easy. Reason they're making this look really easy.
Yeah. And I haven't really seen a crack which AliGon can expose so far as Reason's defense is. So I'm trying to think here. What should the first thing, I think they should stop rush outside.
Yeah.
But this could be something. But Kadian's peeking the legs.
I like that though, that he knew that the one shot wouldn't kill him.
Yeah.
So he could actually have some time there for a shot. That's kind of cute. could have worked, but...
But look at the HP. I don't think the terrorists have even seen a CT yet. And they're already down to basically 150 health between two players.
This almost feels like, if we just check the money, that they should just save at this point. Because with that amount of health, they didn't gain any ground. That's the big deal, I guess. And they use nades. So they're going to go for outside, perhaps? Bomb is still dropped, though, towards T-spawn. So what is their plan here? Looks like they're moving through to Yard, but they're just getting picked off one by one. And Nila just knows, and his only HMP. He's going to save that AWP, surely. Although it looks like it's not.
He doesn't really have the time for it. 35 seconds. Everyone's pushing everywhere.
HMP with two. Might be a third. He's going to run into another. Just spots ahead of NSL. And that's the end of HMP's AWP. And that's... I don't know. It's hard to really... I mean, this is why this was a surprise map choice. A surprise that we could see this map. Because even, you know, Nuke is going to be a lot easier for them to play on the T side. I should think, at least.
I think they should really stop this. This is getting almost...
They're going to do it into the works, man. That's how it's going to go. They are stubborn. And it seems like they're getting some... Well, any extra to get taken down at the moment. MSL does get caught on that flank. Very cheeky, gets punished by Zelos. And that's a 3-on-3.
This could work out, actually, because they made a mistake. They shouldn't have pushed the inner.
Oof.
Oh, wow.
Zelos and Delpan left to try to finish things off here. Zelos actually in Pop Dog. Delpan moving alone right here through to the B-bomb site. Although Zelos is the one with the bomb. Oh, my God. Kadian is just there. He must have heard that.
He heard him.
That Delpan's there. He's looking for the jump, and he hits the flick shot. What a shot from Delpan, the man with the AWP. And Zelos is going to be able to get the bomb down just because of Delpan's amazing AWP play. That's a shot he's not going to connect, but it's... The nade might just do it. Not quite. Delpan's there ready. See if he's able to bring PNX down. What seems like an unkillable, immortal soldier. And Zelos has his back. That was a really... I mean, that just shows you the individual skill that we have at play from AliGon.
Yeah.
But it was a very weird round. So let's see now if AliGon are able to bring some momentum back into the game. And I wonder if they're just going to keep on cracking outside. I don't know. We're going to see Delpan.
I like Delpan making a move, trying to get a pick. But I think they should fake inner before, so Kadian's AWP can't shoot him in the leg before it. Maybe throw a splash, maybe throw a smoke down lower, so the rotation comes inside. Because the problem of them actually going team main is Kadian's AWP peeking them their legs. So I think something like that could work out.
Oh, and Delphine's will one jump across, but there's another player to his left. Does he know that grenade should tell him he's actually going to fall back? That's a good choice from Delpan. They did lose HMP, so now it's up to plan B. They've got to figure something else out. If we check out all their positions across the map, they're very spread out. Nila is actually pushing quite fast here. Oh no, he actually fell back now. He was quite pushed on Ali. And we do have players from AliGon all over the place now, but it looks like they're going for that split
they're
onto
very
Ray.
Spread out. And it's all about if they get the first bag, it could become a domino effect, but it's working in the other direction, and Reason just clean up the round. AliGon doesn't seem to have any answers.
Yeah, that round looked like they were saying to themselves, we want to take one-on-ones, and then if we win our one-on-ones, we win the round. That's kind of what it looked like, and they lost their one-on-ones. I think all of them but Pyth lost their one-on-ones, so. But 8-4 isn't horrendous. I mean, if they can just get a couple more on the board, they're going to be comfortable, I guess. But they're going to go outside again. MSL with the scar. And things look very bad here for AliGon on the Antico, but just throwing their lives away towards A, as they have done so many times previous to this. Now we're a 9-4. We're closing up on the last couple rounds here, and we really need to see, or rather, AliGon really need to see themselves through to at least one more.
Yeah. And they do have a scout in team main by Sevis. Doesn't get the connection. There's Are they leaving Kaden high with all? Or... Yeah. Kaden is holding inside by himself.
We go for the re-peek, and there is a smoke as well. Good smoke there from Kadian. And they're just playing it pretty slow at this point. There was a nice scout shot connected onto PNX, actually, from Zevez. Kind of working Ali now with that scout, as we can see. Going to look for that shot there onto MSL. MSL has a scar, though, so he's pretty dangerous. Scar's better than the scout. It's just better. There it is. Scar rattling off in the distance. He does take down Zevez indeed on Ali. And it looks like the two one-on-ones we just saw just absolutely lost there by AliGon. But now they're going to commit to this B play. Here they go, charging on into the site. Pyth does get the entry frag. That's so crucial. Kadian there with the orb, looking for the angles. Can't quite find them just yet. MSL with the scar, though, is going to find his. And it's all on Delpan now to make it happen. But Kadian shuts him down. And now we're going to move into the last round of the half. And... we have 10 rounds for the game.
I don't know if I can remember a round where they lost two players recent to AliGon's actual
attack. Look at that money, it's sick.
Yeah, I think the eco they had, they killed two players, but that was basically it.
Yeah,
I don't think I remember any other round, except the one they won, of course, but... they're now going for a fast inside, which is a play I like. They might be able to catch Kaden off guard here, and they do. And the rotation is so slow.
So they do have a chance to bring it back in this one round to get to five. If they can get to five rounds, they're going to feel much better.
Yep.
But there'll be a lot of pressure on winning that pistol. But right now, Zelos has a great angle. This is such an amazing... Oh, he doesn't get the second kill, though. No double for him. PNX could change everything in this round. Coming in down from that slope. Coming in with the flank. Pyth shuts him down. MSL, though, with that scar, pops off the head of Zevez. Looking for that next frag onto Pyth. It's a one-on-one. No scoping him down. It looks like this scar from MSL is going to seal the deal. The bomb is defused, and that's an 11-4 scoreline for reason. And four rounds is definitely not an unwinnable result, but
no,
it's tough.
But the worst part of it is that AliGon won the T pistol. They got three rounds, and then they just got crushed when Reason played their CT setup. And Reason didn't change their setup once. They just played the same setup all the time, which is the scary part. I don't know. They had no answers, AliGon.
Right. They didn't force them to adapt to anything,
no,
basically. It's just, they're just so good.
And we'll see what happens now. Seems like they faked a pop rush and going higher.
Interesting. It's gonna... the range advantage should be with
Kaden in the ladder.
Wow, Pi's gonna get dropped there over towards A. And it's a very chaotic round, but we're at a 3-on-3 here. Reason pushed to a defense on this bomb site. HMP coming in with a great frag onto Exa, and it's a one man standing. It's PNX who's going to be moving in now. He's got to take down two players. Oh, he goes straight for that, the one on the distance, and HMP, great round from him.
Yeah,
he's going to help out
very
massively.
Important. And I think you missed it, but I think Kadian jumped down and died in the ladder, like Pyth.
Yeah,
Pyth ladder.
Broke his legs.
Them ladders. It's actually... the ladders in CSGO is pretty difficult to have an agreement with.
Take some skills.
Yeah.
Gotta practice your ladder climbing a couple hours a day.
Yeah. That's warm up.
So they're gonna make their way in here. Into yard, they're gonna just go and die. HMP. Oh, look at this. Look at this. It's... he adapts so fast with his aim, brilliant. I mean,
yep.
HMP is just a monster. I haven't really gotten to see HMP showcased, but this is... I have a lot of respect from what I'm seeing. The gather hero.
The gather hero, yeah. And I'm kind of lost to why Reason is forced buying. They have so few nades. They obviously have to try for a very, very good round. But I'm interested in how it's going to work out. It's like they're going for that pistol play again. The free hire, faking the outside play.
Zervus's position here is very awkward indeed. They did get down onto that B bomb site though. PNX there looking for that kill. He gets HMP. That's going to secure that bomb plant for his team. Reason, AliGon moving in with Zervus through connector. They are fast on this aggression. They're going to come around Delpan, mowing them down with a P90. MSL gets a trade, but that Delpan P90 is too good. Exa though has a lot of work to do here. The tap off the heads of these players does get Zelos, but they're both looking. Gotta go for the defuse. This is tense. He can actually make this happen still. Be huge, but Exa will go down. Well played by AliGon there for the retake of the B bomb site. He has the time,
they get
right?
The plant and.
Oh my god, that was close. Oh god, it went wide. That was close.
Yeah, and Pyth had a kit the whole time.
Pyth is laughing at him. But maybe it's Delpan's fault. He wants those points.
Yeah.
He wants those those defuse points, man. It used to be defuse frags. That used to be the thing.
Everyone went for the defuse.
Yeah.
It's like no one wants to hold the guy defusing, and now it's kind of the. You want to get the frag instead of the defuse now.
I like this little spot here from Delpan. Beast is kind of slightly above those sandbags.
Reason is going for a similar push AliGon did, but it's on eco. They're trying to get the plant. Got a kill with it. So, successful eco from Reason. Got two players now.
Really nice stuff here coming in from Reason. Kadian going for another, but probably ran out of bullets by this point. Spamming down near there, but what a result. Two frags and a bomb plant. Wham bam, thank you ma'am.
Yep, that's really good. So they might be able to afford an AWP now. Yeah, so they're going for the AWP. Kadian is picking it up, and they have full nades on everyone. And yeah, if they get a bomb plant on this round, they can even buy the next one. So yeah, pretty good money because of that bomb plant.
Yeah, 11-8. This is looking a lot better for AliGon, but of course, a lot of work ahead of them still. So it's going to be no easy task against Reason, who I'm sure have much more experience as a team on this map than they do playing the T side. AliGon with only one man on B at the moment. They're putting someone on in here. Looks like they're not 100% sure exactly what's happening. Ooh, Delpan spotting two. Maybe even tagging PNX through that first player.
I think so.
So that's a very nice connection there from Delpan. That's going to stop AliGon from pushing in. That's him keeping that position, which is very, very important. And Reason now, they've got to go for plan B. But what is plan B?
Seems like an outside split where kind of a lurker role on both the main guy and the pop dog, waiting for the contact on Ali. But it seems like that's not really what they went for. My mistake. They went for the one-on-one duels instead.
And this is a very troubling spot here for Reason. There's a lot of money on Kadian with that AWP, and this has got to be a save. Or a try to survive round, because they're going to hunt them. Look at this, they're all going to go for the hunt. This is going to be interesting. Nelo with one. Oh, he's going to get a second too. And that's a good result so far. And actually, AliGon are going to be careful. They don't want to lose too much money here.
No, it's true. Oh, nade.
Oh, nice grenade. Just Kadian left now. Do they go for this? Looks like they do.
I think they're waiting for the timer. Counter terrorists
win. Wow. Definitely surprised that Kadian missed that shot, actually. That's usually one he's going to hit. But there you go. Removing Kadian. Removing the AWP from Kadian. Always good to do if you can pull it off. Reason 11-9 now.
And let's see if Reason can actually find a hole in AliGon's defense. Seems like they haven't really so far. As AliGon's playing a pretty different style, but still defensive style.
And look at this, they're just jumping straight in. They're going straight for the plant. And it goes down just before he dies. And Zelos putting in some mad work here. We've got Exo and PNX left, just Exo now. Exa over at B, so he's gonna be late to the party as they go for the defuse now. Gonna try to get that AWP and get out of there. They're gonna be hunting him down, but there's not much time. He's gonna survive. So 11-10, AliGon are about to tie up the game.
Yeah, and it's actually AliGon in a really, really good position because they have all the money in the world and they're soon up on rounds, equal part equal in par with the Reason, so Reason's gotta find the answer soon.
I wonder what they're gonna find in this round. Again, they've got quite a presence on Ali. The last few times they did it, hasn't really worked out for them. It's been locked down quite well so far. And Cadian, they're going to work that orb. Oh, he's going to find the pick in the face. Pyth goes down. And that is a fantastic pick. And there's so much time left, they might even just wait to see what happens.
Look how defensively the CTs are set up. Like, they're not even holding the yard area. Maybe they're trying to get a rotation to the inner bomb site. But it seems like AliGon is actually...
Cadian to go for another shot, connects it onto Zelos. Cadian putting in mad work in this round to bring Reason back into the forefront. And HMP with a good kill, but it's looking like things are very tough. Delpan, ooh, just missing that next shot. Under a lot of pressure to perform here, and he might get flanked. He's got to be careful of that Ali approach. And the bomb does go down. Zevis, ooh, Cadian's getting tagged. Wow, just catching Zevis' head in the air. Delpan moving in.
Yeah, one on three.
And Nilla's going to do it. So that was a very important round for Reason.
It's kind of... Reason did what I kind of wanted AliGon to do. Kind of make a slow outside push, so the inner pushes later don't get so obvious. That worked out really well for Reason, with Cadian getting two entries in the same spot in 15 seconds. They just got the entry shield, went for the peak again, the shield, and then they just executed their push.
So the timing couldn't have been better for Reason to pick up another round to kind of break that momentum from AliGon. They started to really run away with things, I think, and I wonder if they're going to try it again. If it ain't broke, don't fix it, as the saying goes.
Yeah, and I think they are. Seems like they're going towards the same setup, but this time it might be a fake with two Ali and three inner.
They're all over the place. Let's see if they can make this fake work. Boom, MSL going to take down Zelos. That is, as you said, a good way to sell the fake.
Yeah.
As he makes his way through Ali and all the way through CT spawn, so we can support this push on to B. Delpan going to shut him down, though. And they know what's up at this point. And maybe a bit too slow on the push into the B bombsite. Delpan with another great shot onto PNX to shut down this fake. And Pyth coming in with a flank. And he's going to... Oh, wow, Cadian. I don't believe it. Turning around, popping him in the head with that AWP. HMP, there's so many flanks going on in this round.
Yeah, this is crazy.
And they're all the way back over to A once again. Here is the plan, finally. It's a 2-on-2, Cadian and Exa so weak, but Delpan working with that AWP, and he's got Zevis to support him. And Zevis coming in with another flank, and there it is, perfect onto Cadian. It's now on Exa, who's over by the T-Sky ladder. This is going to be so tough for him. He's got to play with the sound here. There goes the defuse, but he's against two players. They're looking at the angle, and he missed. He can't even shoot a bullet. And that's it. That's going to be the round for AliGon. Can you break down that round? I'm confused.
I think it was exactly like you said. They made the push inner too late, as they already sold the fake and the rotation was coming outside. They had one guy inner, but as soon as Delphan saw, they were actually trying to push towards spawn. He knew instantly it was a split towards inner. And he just rotated instantly and got a pick up high exactly when they pushed in. So good call from Delphan, and he changed that round.
Oh, wow, PNX doing a lot of damage with the Glock, but picked up. Zevis unable to connect anything. And there you go, finally catching a fair onto HMP. And Cadian making his way forwards with the CZ. 1-on-2, they've done very well with this.
Expensive round for AliGon. They win it, but lost three guns, and they don't manage to pick up the AWP. So that's a really expensive round.
Yeah.
This could be the turning point for Reason is looking for.
So what seemed like a crazy map for AliGon and Reason to both want to play on, and what seemed like such a scary half for AliGon first half, we're actually seeing a really tight match between these two teams for this this grand final for the DreamHack Summer Qualifiers. HMP actually in PNX's position. Let's see if he's able to do better than Phoenix did. Phoenix did bloody well.
Yeah, he was a game changer over at that heaven and hell position, and seems like Reason is kind of undecisive. They don't really know what they want to do. They kind of have the setup where they kind of can go everywhere. It's just about getting the info. I think they want to maybe... Yeah, this is dangerous.
I just like Nilla's going to make a distraction or something here. But they have a player over towards Team Main. I'm not really sure what his role is in all this. Unless he's timed out or something or AFK, I don't know. But unless I'm missing a player or if that's a bugged minimap, I'm not sure. Either way, it's actually Kadian. He's going to... Okay, they're going to fake onto A. And they're going to hopefully... be faster with the fake this time. Oh, Kadian getting pushed. Very, very timely push there. Very important. Nilla going to come out of alley now. Zebes over at B. He's like, what is going on up the ladder? Oh, they managed to take him down. Kadian, Exa, PNX are remaining to try to get this bomb planted here over at B. They managed to do it.
That bomb's really, really low. Kadian has a grenade, but he's not in the rotation yet. This is interesting. CTs are pushing really quickly right now. Kadian needs to land the shot. He doesn't.
Just Exa left and he cannot do it. Exa falls. AliGon are going to take another round. And let's just check out the money here. It's not looking good for Reason right now. They did get the bomb plant. But because it's so back and forth, I mean, I guess they could scrap together a buy with some Galils. But, I mean, they're going to have not really any nades. And it's awkward. They're going to go for it. So I guess
I do think that they might want to go for. Well, this seems like they're going for some kind of outer plant round. Could be the fake again towards inner, but this time seems like they're actually committing towards outside.
Oh, Pies! Great first shot, but that's all it's going to be from him. Oh, the bomb is going to go down through the smoke. Cheeky stuff coming in from Reason. On this buy round, it's a 3-on-4 right now, though. Kadian is just blind, choking on smoke.
Still a 3-on-2 on the after plant. It's doable, still.
Let's see if Reason have it in them. Right now, there's Exa. There's Nilla. Bomb ticking away. It's ticking quite far now. They're both getting their 1-on-1 successfully. It's just on Zevas, unable to do anything. And this is so back and forth right now. This is crazy. The money is getting really scary.
AliGon doesn't have any money.
Yeah.
They bought auto snipers. They sacrificed. They put so much money into the last round and didn't pay off. And wow. Man. Seems like Reason is going to go up on 14 rounds.
Auto snipers like 2M for A1S. Come on.
Yeah.
Oh, God. It's definitely looking very awkward for them now. Delpan's in a very pushed position. He's gonna be able to find anything here. Oh, he does find one frag. That's actually two frags there. So they do go a man up, but the weapon advantage is in favor of the Danes right now. Zeres. Oh, he does get some good damage. If there's a nade to toss in, that would be fantastic. Reason gonna get that plant down, and they're looking to make a good defense here with these AKs. Should go well for them. Only Galil's to worry about. There it is. Kadian spotted it.
It's very important that Kadian Holt is surviving now.
Oh, dear.
Cannot die from the flank.
And Kadian goes down. So AliGon, they make it work with a random ass buy coming in from AliGon. And they do it. Somehow, some way, they make it work. And they're moving into the next round. 14 to 13, round for round for round. Neither team can quite seem to pull ahead more than a couple at this point.
This is interesting. Seems like Reason is going for
overtime.
Yeah.
Interesting. I guess it makes sense. I guess you need nades on this map, I suppose. So
true.
It'd be pretty awkward.
They're going for the plant round again.
Pipe doing his best scream impressions before he results to going to the get right. And HMP going to make his way with the flank. It's really successful, although there is still Kadian left standing, but they only lost two players, so that they can deal with that. They can definitely deal with that. Kadian. Oh, they got the bomb down as well. That's obviously really nice. So Kadian, if he can maybe get one more frag, that's going to be amazing. an amazing round for Reason. It's defused though, and he does make the kill. Oh, he gets on the hop as well. No way. What was that? What the hell?
That one of that eco frag got punished.
Is it worth that? That's just, oh my god. It's like Christmas for KD in there, like yeah. All falling from the sky.
That was jackpot. Just waiting there again.
Yeah. Yeah. Alright, so AliGon and one round away from winning this. It is so tense right now, but Cadian is in an amazing position. If they get cocky, if they push up, then they are dead. That is not a good choice. And look at this. Everyone is just around Pop Dog here. AliGon, they probably heard some stepping. I think they've heard some sound cues. They know something's up.
Yeah, and Xelos goes aggressive alley and picks up Nilla in a defensive position there. So I think they're rotating inside pretty quickly now because alley was clear. And yeah.
Oh, this is so hard. This is going to be so difficult. After getting that information, they're just moving too slow. AliGon are going to be all over them. They're going to be completely on top of them. Xelos is just charging towards Ali just in case something crazy is going to happen. And we see Cadian is going to go for the drop here down towards that bomb site. He's the last man standing against four players with the AWP. He's going to come out huge.